get through. Me on my way to you.
Thank you. Welcome to the world of Elysium, a voice boomed from the helmet. I had just plugged into the world's first virtual reality video game made since the government crash back in 2013. I was only 10 when it happened. I didn't really remember much about it aside from the fact that it happened. Welcome to the new world, Elysium, your new Casa de Not Broken country. The bombastic voice that played whenever a data tech helmet was plugged in was a little cheesy, I'll admit. But you know what? When everything else hits the fan, sometimes a little cheese can go a long way. I took one step and let my foot come down. Another step followed like I was wading through jelly. As I kept trying, it felt more natural until I didn't think about it at all. My avatar resembled me. I've never been the creative kind of person. It never made sense for me to make something that didn't look anything like me. So, the created character section was pretty short, sweet, and to the point. Raven hair, green eyes, a thin nose, a skinny face. Took some time to fit inside my body. Outside the archway was a darkened hallway that I had to feel against the wall to keep straight. There was a pungent, musty smell that clung to the walls. It sent my mind reeling as I backed away from it to steady myself. I looked down at my hands, more to where they were since it was so dark. They felt like gloves, not quite the feeling of skin, but it was close.
If you focus on your footsteps, you can hear that they thought to make it sound different down here.
A voice called out from my right.
They really put in that little detail, and most people wouldn't even care to listen, you know?
I jumped and turned towards the sound of the voice. I squinted and could barely see thin shapes running from the ground to the ceiling. They were prison bars. I stepped closer and could see through them much better than out in the hallway. A figure was lying on top of a cot hanging by two rope strands on the wall. He had long reddish-brown hair tied under a brown headband. The only other part of him I could see, and the first thing after his hair, was the crimson armor he sat in. He shook his head and yawned. Who?
Oh, shit! I didn't actually expect anybody to be there. I kept imagining I was hearing those footsteps, so I've been saying that, hoping I'll attract someone to come and help me out. I never expected it actually work.
What are you doing in there?
I've been in here for a while. I played when it was in beta, and it seems that progress does indeed transfer over. Just my luck. I basically nuked that account because I assumed the server would be wiped for release and everybody would start new.
So you got yourself locked in there?
Yeah, I was a little annoying trying to ask for raid partners. I could be a bit... much. Other people said so and I guess I understand, but I can't really help it, can I? It's supposed to be a 10-hour timeout. I don't remember if I waited for any of it back in beta. Hell, I doubt I did.
So, you've got 10 whole hours in there? That's harsh, I said. What's your username?
Klein. And you?
He nodded. Dex, I said. I'm not stupid enough to use my real name, but I guess it's just like my avatar. An approximate, with variants. Ah, so it's like a roguelike. Klein looked at me with a confused look.
You're not aware?
No spoilers. I told you I was coming in blind.
That's a lot of faith, man.
Or I just heard word and wanted to check it out.
That's a very expensive taste to just check out. But you do you. I hope it's worth it.
I shrugged.
So where are you from? Don't worry. I'm just curious. Nothing more.
I'm from Colorado, I said.
Well, I assumed. Regional servers and all that. Town. I'm from Thornton.
Sheesh, I didn't know. I'm from Aurora.
Sorry. That's my, personality getting a little thorny again. I guess that's what people didn't like. Hey, Dex. Are you okay? You don't look so good.
I shook my head. Don't worry about it. You're not too far, all things considered. Every player in this game is subject to die in the real world if we die in this one. A horrible realization dawned on me. I remember those players we encountered back outside Elysium. I saw their roped figures being cut down, one by one, each one shattering into nothing. We had killed them. One of my golden rules, broken, just like that. With a swing, a bunch of zeros and ones, a life had ended. I took a step back and Klein noticed me. I backed away, taking one step after another. One more back and I tripped over my own feet. People began stampeding around me, trying to find an exit, or at least a way up the next floor. I felt like I was going to throw up. I was sure if this were the real world, I would have broken some bones in the stampede. Yet I lie here, unharmed in this world in which we are prisoners. This world that I was a murderer.
Fine. I'll join you,
she said as a matter of fact. She opened up the window and sent the invite.
But don't be mistaken. I've got my own reasons for getting ahead in this game. This is just for this one floor,
she added. I accepted her invitation and let loose a grin. In that case, I guess it will be a pleasure to work with you. I'm Dex. I extended my hand.
Athena,
she said, leaving my hand in the air, her arms folded. Like the Greek goddess? I asked, letting it drop slowly. I met with a stare that seems to say,
what else would it be of? You still have your default sword,
she said, looking around me to my sheath.
Passion and attitude can only get you so far. You're going to need to go outfit yourself at the armory. There's one in this town. Just follow the road down from here and go past the pub. I don't want you dying on me right when we start because of a default sword.
Where and when should we meet up after? I asked.
I have some errands to run myself. Do you know the big fountain in the park? It should have been near where you were before.
So, you were watching me, I said, a grin plastered on my face.
Not now.
She shook her head.
I'll be there in a few hours. I'll only stay until 7. If you're not there, I'm gone. Got it?
She had her hands on her hips, looking at me dead in the eyes.
Good. Now hurry up. I'll get what I need to be done, and I expect you to do the same,
she said, and then walked off. I watched her coattails trail behind her. She turned a corner, and then she was gone. I waited another 10 seconds, and then I could feel my whole body go limp. The adrenaline was still rushing through my veins. I'm pretty sure it was the only thing keeping me talking. Athena, I said quietly to myself. It's just the adrenaline from this whole ordeal. Nothing more, nothing less. It's gonna be just as she said. We're gonna team up for this next floor, and then part ways. No attachments. A notification popped open in front of me, alerting me I had a message. It was from Klein.
Oh my god. Dude, I didn't think you'd actually get us a shake. I got the notification that Athena joined our party. Is she hot?
I took a look at the sky and laughed, letting the humility and insecurity return and the adrenaline fade. Yes.
Good to see you're up and moving. I got a notification in my pie menu that you'd woken up. Don't think I'm stalking you or anything.
I waved my hand at him, brushing the subject off. What happened? Klein walked and grabbed a chair, pulled it over, and sat down.
You passed out? Through the whole fight you look queasy, so I guess I'm not really surprised. Athena bailed. I could tell that the whole mess was devastating for her. I don't blame her for needing time to herself. On the bright side, we did get this.
He reached out to his menu and swiped through quickly to bring out the gem that had hung around Eldon's neck.
It was the only thing that remained of him when he...
His gaze dropped.
You know.
I nodded.
I've seen one of them before, yeah, but never up close. They're called keystones. This one's dubbed the Heart of Ares.
Do you know anything about it?
They're supposed to unlock a great treasure higher up if the 8 of them are collected.
And they're held by bosses?
I don't know about all of them. I'd say that's a safe assumption, though.
What happened to the other players? The ones who were going to go onto the second floor? I asked, turning my head. I saw a few of them on my way to the armory, you know, I said. Now that I think about it, so many people would have died if Eldon had led all those people to the second floor.
I'm sure with all those people he would have gone taken down eventually. But you're right, they would have taken so many people by surprise. It isn't possible to think of how many would have died to that momentary loss of composure.
How long have you been looking at me?
That's a loaded question. A better one would be, how long did you know?
I didn't look up. I recognized the voice immediately. Only just now. I'm not in my best game lately.
You took the words right out of my mouth.
Something like that, I said.
Listen, I understand that it's probably not the wisest decision, but I need to be alone for a bit. I have a lot I need to unpack, and I could be the cause of a mistake if I'm bogged down.
Are you sure? I asked. We could use every person we could get. She gripped her fists tight.
I'm sure you'll find more than enough help. I can't.
She turned on her heels.
I'm glad you're okay. You passed out back at the fight.
She looked back to me for a second and then shook her head.
And I think for the slightest of seconds I knew why. Ignore me. Stay alive and beat this game for us, okay?
She turned and continued away from me. I watched her leave and returned to my spot by the stairs.
Hey, you feeling okay?
Klein behind me said. He looked down at me. The wolf shattered completely, and I fell to the ground with a thud. I blinked and saw the kid standing in front of me. He offered a hand to help me up. Thanks, I said, taking it, but using my own weight to stand up. I'm pretty sure I'd take you down too. I thought I was a goner, the kid said. I'm not gonna let that happen, I said. What are you doing out here? He said. My dad put me here. He started to get choked up again. Have you seen my dad? Klein patted my back and gave me a jolt. I looked at him and saw the other wolves had been taken care of. Of course, that armor of his must have been hard for the wolves to make any sort of dent. What kind of parent ditches their kid here? I asked, looking up to Klein.
Kids astray? Jeez. That sucks.
Klein chose his words carefully. I just want my dad! He bawled out. Okay, calm down, I said, kneeling down and placing a hand on his shoulder. You're not gonna be alone, okay? You're gonna have us as bodyguards. I looked up to Klein. Right?
Yeah.
Klein crossed his arms.
Can't very well just leave a kid here by himself.
Bodyguards? The kid asked and wiped his face. Yeah, we'll try to find your dad and bring you back to him. And until then, we'll make sure you don't get hurt anymore, I said.
Here, take this.
Klein offered up a potion to the kid.
I see the bite on your leg. It must hurt. This will make them feel better. And it doesn't taste like crap, like normal medicine.
Klein, I called.
What? Don't tell me you're going to scold me for saying crap. What are you, 10?
The kid took a swig of the potion and downed it in one big gulp. Yeah, what are you, 10? He coughed once and patted his chest. My name's Sam. Who are you? Clever kid to redirect his sass. I'm Dex, and this is Klein. And we're trying to make it out of this game. His eyes opened wide. Yeah, I couldn't get out of here. My dad said it was impossible.
Well, it isn't. It's just not available right now. We're trying to fix that. We're gonna make our way to the top and beat this game.
Sam nodded. That sounds good. I want to beat this game too. I want to come with you. Well then, it looks like we're in agreement. But you need to stay safe, okay? We'll handle the monsters, I added. Speaking of, I stood back up and walked to the side and grabbed Elcor, sliding it back into its sheath. Sam walked up to me and offered his hand. Does this mean you're my friend? Sure, little buddy. Friend. I shook.
I've got it, dude. You both go on,
Klein said. I looked at him and nodded. We started off toward the sound. The world shook again under the roar. Trees toppled in the distance. We both saw it and kept pace. We kept running and leaping over fallen trees. That was when we saw it. A terrible creature. That was the thing. It didn't really look like just one creature. It looked like a bunch of them mashed together. It was much larger than the wolves Klein and I had seen. Much larger. It was the size of a building. It looked to have the body of a lion, but on the back of its head where a mane would have been was a second head. One of a goat fused together with the lion's. Instead of a bushy tail at the rear of the creature, instead a thick, scaly snake took its place. It stood at its full height and let loose a terrifying scream to the heavens above. What the hell is that thing? I yelled, ducking behind a tree. Luna was as wide-eyed as I was. The enemy window said it's a boss. Its name is the Ultimate Chimera. Wait, what's that around its neck? Its neck? I asked. I hadn't thought to look up at the neck since I was so preoccupied with the outlandishness of the rest of it. I saw a small orange crystal hanging from the beast's neck like a pin. The shape easily came to mind. It has another keystone! I found a seat and a chair at the far end of the room. Klein placed Sam down on the bed and stretched, relieved of holding the sleeping child. Luna sat on the edge of the bed, looking back to make sure Sam was okay before she did. Have you heard back from Gregor? I asked. He shook his head, and I took a deep breath in response. Damn, what do you think happened?
I don't know. He could be asleep. That's always a possibility.
Something just isn't sitting right with me, I said. Something strange caught my eye behind Luna. Sam's body looked to be flickering. Is Sam okay? I asked. She furrowed her brow and then turned around. What? She slid over to him and tried to place a hand on him, but it went right through to the sheets. I don't understand.
Sam's not real. He's a fake, a sham, a program, and nothing but meant to lure, deceive, and otherwise trick. there's no longer any reason to do so. So he's gone. Really, it is that simple.
I looked at him, a sinking feeling in my chest. What do you mean? He smiled, like every other one of his smiles. He stood up, stretching once more and placing his hands behind him. Klein, what the fuck are you talking about? This isn't funny, I said.
No, it's not particularly funny. But then again, it wasn't really intended to be. That feeling inside of you that's building, it's right.
So you're him? Klein smiled again. He tapped his foot on the ground as if impatient, but his face said that he could do this all day. Slowly, I started to see changes form in his facial features. What I had known as Klein had completely disappeared from his face. It melted away, growing older, and we were face to face with a man I didn't recognize. He had hazel eyes and short blonde hair. He cocked his head.
You can call me Jack. I've been looking for you for some time. I am glad to know that no time was wasted.
He walked over to me, looking down. Me? I asked. What do you mean? And what the hell do you think you're doing keeping us in this game? This is you, right?
Yes, this land is of my will. I care very little about how much you understand of it. My purpose under the name Klein was simply to confirm a theory. I have, and will now be taking my leave.
Leave? Oh, fuck no, buddy. I stood up, nearing his face. We found you. You're letting everyone out of here.
Well, you didn't find me if I revealed myself.
He held his arms up theatrically.
And I don't think I shall. But you tried, and in the end, it may not matter, but you can take some solace in the fact that it was a solid attempt.
Well, that was your mistake, I said. We've got you cornered in this room. Jack's face lit up.
Do you actually think I'd be so foolish to leave myself defenseless? This body here is an extension of my own will. You can try to kill me if you would like, but I exist separately. You would gain nothing and lose much. Do you still dare to try?
I gritted my teeth. You bastard! You son of a bitch!
Language, Andrew. I would have thought your mother would have taught you better. Oh yes, I know all about you. Didn't I say I was looking for you?
It felt like a rod was jammed up my spine. He looked at me with incredulity. He smiled at my horror and stood up tall.
Well, if that's all then, I'll be taking my leave. If you're so penchant you can try to find me, keep climbing your ladder, boy, and you just might find what you're looking for. If not, then enjoy this world I've built as long as you can. It'll be my greatest gift to you. You made a wise decision staying still. Your life is spared.
You think I believe your croc? She asked. Hardly. Luna drew out her bow and fired an arrow. It soared through Klein, who grinned but didn't move.
Well, not as wise as I initially guessed. You just don't understand. But that's okay. It'll click in time.
What do you want? I asked. This seemed to surprise him. He turned from her to me. You obviously want something. You said to find me. What? Is it to kill me? Why are you here?
Kill you? It's hardly that simple. Why?
He walked over to me, throwing out an arm and grasping my throat in an instant. I felt his cold grip seal around my neck.
I could do that right now. I could have done it back when we first met or when you fainted after Elden died. My goal isn't to kill you, Andrew. But don't be mistaken. You won't make it out of this game alive. My goals don't guarantee your safety.
Without another word, he vanished from our view as if he never existed.
Listen, you need to keep it together. There's something you need to know about the police.
Jay said.
You know Adada? The company that made Elysium? Of course, that's why you're here. The police are in league with them.
League? Why? And you still haven't answered me what you're doing here.
First things first. I used to work with the people that made this death game. The people that are doing dirty deals with the police to allow it to be made without interference. And I quit when I found out about how deep this went. I'm here now trying to stop them and save these people that are trapped inside of the game. I can't speak for your friend, but this is the kind of thing the people responsible for this are known to do.
Jake was more than just anyone. He was my best friend. I started to choke up and my breathing got short way too fast. I can't stop seeing it. I try to close my eyes and it's still there.
They took my boy from me. His name was John. These people take until no more can be taken. That's what Jack Adada was born to do.
I can still make my own choices. You didn't drag me out here, I heard in my head. It was true. It hurt, but it was true. It wasn't anyone's fault but for the reason for us being out here. Jack Adada caused all this. No, I couldn't be naive. Both of us have accountability. We did choose to come out here. I'll have to live with that decision. But it was important that I live. I knew that is what he'd tell me right now. What kind of hero could I be if I died here? What kind of sister would I be if I died? I'm sorry about your son, I said, breaking my silence. My name's Jennifer Kress, but just call me Jen. There was a momentary flash in his eyes. I looked at him and in them I felt open. He felt like a teacher, like someone I could trust. I want to help my brother. He's currently trapped in that dumb game.
You mean Andrew?
How?
I worked with it, Kress.
He hesitated.
Quite some time ago when I was working here. Not on video games, mind you, but none of us were at the time.
My father's name was David, I said. He nodded and smiled, but it was a sorrowful look. One that carried a lot of tough memories. Yeah, it's been such a long time. I didn't even get to know him, I said. Jay treaded carefully.
Yes, he died about 14 years ago, didn't he? That's about when I left. Well, I am very sorry for your loss. All of them. But I must say this isn't a safe place for you to remain.
I shook my head. I came all the way here, and I shouldn't even need to say it. I came to help my brother, and I'm gonna make that happen. I can't go back, not without knowing he's okay. So, like, what's it made of, and what does it do?
I'm privy to the details for my own safety, but I understand that makes me sound suspicious. So, I can tell you, so long as you don't go posting about it online or what have you.
Yeah, sure.
Radical 9 is mainly made of elementary particles, calcium and radium mixed with two particles not found on Earth.
So where? Like, the moon?
Mars. Now we have to wait for it to dry. Whatever you do, don't touch it.
What happens if you do?
Well, the human brain is full of electrical activity. If the human body makes contact with the Radical 9, then no good can come of it, surely. There was an accident, and it got one of my co-workers killed. Very much drove another mad. That other is the very same person behind the Elysium game, Jack Adada.
Where did this stuff come from? Was it what was being made here? What you worked on? A blood-curdling scream pierced the air and was accented by the ticking clock. Luna and I looked at one another and immediately ran towards the source of the voice. We darted down the street past a couple of other players who were frozen in place by the scream. We continued until we saw the gargantuan figure responsible for causing the sound, standing in front of what looked to be a water fountain. Is that Gregor? I asked. Standing in front of the fountain in black armor was the lovable oaf who had given me my shroud of darkness. He was holding a huge two-sided hammer in both of his hands, the likes of which had just finished squishing the head of another player. His brains were smashed to bits, and the survivor of his party, another guy roughly around my age, tried to run away. Gregor wasn't going to let him go that easy. A second Gregor split from the first like he were some sort of amoeba. The second one leaped the distance in a matter of seconds, catching up to the other player. Gregor swept the handle of his hammer on the till and caught the player in the side. His arm bent at an odd angle, and he crumpled to the ground. The second Gregor looked down at the fallen player and stamped on their head. The original Gregor looked up and saw both of us staring at the scene. Around his neck, I saw the heart of Ares alongside a second keystone. It shimmered red along with Ares' gold. It was the heart of Apollo. Gregor, are you kidding me? I said, holding my hand over the hilt of my blade. We just got through this nonsense with Klein. Gregor said nothing as he pressed his fingers around the heart of Ares. He hefted his hammer up over his shoulder and a second copy broke free from his body, charging at us. Shit, I said. Cover me, I called. You got it, Luna said. I ran up to meet the third Gregor. He lifted the gargantuan hammer over his head and I swung my sword out to his legs. He offered a roar and pushed against me with the heft of his weapon. Luna fired two shots over me, one in the sky. The second swung his hammer in an arc and blocked the first two. The third landed perfectly from above and shattered his copy into pixels. The fragments returned back into the original Gregor, who stood by. He lifted and slammed his leg down. Two copies erupted out from his body in a shower of pixel fragments. Two more joined those copies, and then two more. They encircled us. Eight of them in total. What the fuck? Luna said. If his copies have less durability than the original, do you think he has to split his life to make the copies? I don't know, but I don't like it. Cover me? Luna asked. Of course. She unlocked her daggers and I went invisible. She ran forward and struck one of their daggies into a copy's chest. He shattered and returned to the original. Two of them were running towards her from both sides. I thrust my sword into the chest of the one closest to me. Luna spun on her heels and drove her daggers into the chest of the other. Both of them dissipated, revealing a third who thrust his hammer, sending Luna back. She tripped and fell. He towered over her, and I...
Dex!
Athena was standing on the edge of the battlefield, holding her arm. I looked for a fraction of a second, but that was enough time for... Gregor brought his hammer down. No! The world went silent. One of the remaining Gregors picked me up and held me tight. I dropped my sword. I couldn't focus. My vision went blurry. My mind was racing, but no thought stuck. I sat there stunned. I couldn't move, so I just screamed. I saw she was holding her arm out, the one not under her coat, and I took it, still feeling like I was floating in a dream.
Hey, are you there? Hello?
She asked. I looked past her and found Luna's body. I slowly shambled over and stared. Her whole head was caved in. Blood mixed with bone fragments in the gray matter of her brain. I looked and immediately regretted it, turning around and emptying my stomach onto the grass. I let out a cry and felt tears stinging in my eyes. Why? Why? Fuck!
What is she?
Athena asked, her eyes darting from Luna's body to me. She's gone, I said. Because I fucked up. Realization flashed across her eyes.
Oh, my God. I called to you.
I screamed louder and cradled myself together. Please, just go, I said. I can't right now. It's just me left and I can't.
Come on, stand up. You're still alive. Don't waste that. For fuck's sake, don't waste it. This game is fucked and it just takes and takes, but you can't let it take you. You... saw it. I know you did.
I only heard fragments, I answered. I didn't want to assume anything.
What you assume is what happened,
she said.
Please don't hate me.
Hey, you weren't responsible for that. There's no way you could have known what would have happened. We were just trying to survive.
But everything that's happened has just been this giant shitstorm, and it's not fair to expect anyone else to carry that weight, and you shouldn't let other people do it, but I can't. I can't anymore. I'm not strong enough.
It's not that you're not strong enough, I countered. I think if that were the case, you would have given up a long time ago. But you're still here, still fighting. That makes you plenty strong. I just think you haven't had anyone to rely on. A friend isn't about giving them your baggage, but having someone to help carry yours. A friend offers out kindness, not out of obligation. After a moment of silence, I asked her, are you okay out there? Is he still a problem?
No. After the last time Aaron found out.
Your brother, right? What happened? I asked.
They started fighting and I got so scared. It got to the point where Aaron broke me out of my room and we took off.
Just the two of you? Where did you go? Couldn't risk your dad finding you there, right?
Yes, my mom's a whole other can of worms, so she's been out of the picture for a long time. After that, it was just Aaron. There was this run-down apartment complex a town over from where my father lived in Monument. We didn't want to be too close, but at the same time, we couldn't walk across the entire state, so we walked as far as we could. The place we found was trashed, but it had no landlord. Neither of us had any money, so we couldn't pay rent. I was fine with staying in a place that didn't need rent. We had to drop out of our schools, high school for me and college for him. Yeah, this is when he got into Elysium. I guess he felt like he
needed an escape. I finished. I took a deep breath. I know the feeling. I made a lot of mistakes. A lot of the same ones your brother made. I hope I can make them right with her, but I also want to be right by myself. I want to be her brother. Your friend. Me.
I'm so sorry. I want to be your friend too. But there's a part of me that wants to be more, and that's the part that I hate.
Don't hate it, I said. Just don't be so quick to call it like it is. You need to heal, and only you can mentally sort out those feelings. But I don't think you can really love someone until you can love yourself. I know, because I can't really say I truly loved Luna, at least in the way that was healthy. I didn't love myself. I loved what she represented, almost a justification for me inside this game. Maybe in time I could have sorted out those feelings, but it wasn't right for me to shove them to the side as I did.
You really think that'll make a difference?
She asked. Yeah, I do. I have a lot to work on myself, but I can change the world.
You really think that you can make a difference?
She asked me. I do, and I know that you do too. I waited for a response, but none came. I rested my head against the wall and closed my eyes. I almost reached the depths of sleep until I heard the smallest sound.
Hey, Andy,
she said.
I want you to know my name. Since I learned yours, I think it's only right. It's Lindsay. Lindsay Barrett.
That's a nice name, I said. My eyes fluttered shut and I fell unconscious.
You son of a bitch. I should have killed you back at the start.
Lindsay spat at him. Klein cocked his head and looked like he'd just won the lottery.
Yeah, you should have. You wouldn't have been able to, but you should have. Shame. I should have killed you then too. But I didn't. Imagine the generosity I had to demonstrate in saving the life of the person that I thought Andrew here liked. And, get this, he didn't even like you. He liked the white-haired chick who let her end with a mallet. Ah, I wish I could have gotten that hit myself, but I'll take issuing the order.
I will never forgive you, I said. He held out his arms.
But Andrew, look at how things worked out. The three amigos are back. Even if one of us is missing an arm.
The three amigos were never a thing. It was every player and then there was you.
Maybe so. But playing pretend every once in a while is fun, no? Like how I let you get so close with your little scheme here. Do you really think I didn't notice that interference the first time Jennifer entered this game? I could have refused her entry the second I noticed her breaking in.
Why didn't you?
You still don't get it. I needed you to come here. You lost the girl who was going to carry you to the end. You needed someone who would help pull your ass out of the sadness you had. A sadness I fully could not even begin to understand, mind you. But lo and behold came your redemption with the first girlfriend, plus the long-gone sister. It was so perfect, even I couldn't have orchestrated it.
He motioned with his hands. She's not my girlfriend, and I grew on my own accord, I said.
Potato, potato, it's just like I told you from the start.
Jay, I'd appreciate a helping hand here, I called up.
Oh, he can't hear you. I shut him out. It isn't interesting if both sides cheat.
Klein said, his face shifting to Jakadata. It isn't fair if only one side does either.
That is the part where I point at your stupidity, for thinking I play fair.
He pointed on each syllable. Lindsay fell to the ground beside me. Her eyes went lifeless. Lindsay! I called out. Jay's voice cut in, and instantly I recognized Lindsay's body start to vanish, as if it had never existed. I looked up at Jack.
What?
Oh, shut him out, you said? I shook my head, standing to my feet. Oh no, she mattered a whole lot to you. It completed this whole thing for you perfectly, didn't it? Put a whole nice bow on it? What were you gonna do? Kill her and laugh over my newfound depression? His lips snarled as he took a step toward me.
I'm done joking with you.
You never were joking. You never were anything but a maniac, I said, bringing flintlock up and firing around. The bullet and gun vanished from my hand faster than I could fire it. I looked down as the weight simply left my hand.
Trying to use weapons in my own mind against me, like trying to suffocate the ocean with a garden hose.
I'd pissed in the fucking ocean just so you could taste a little bit of humility, I said through bare teeth. Klein held up his arms in defense.
Hey there, what's up, buddy? I bet I'm afraid not there. Oh, I'm afraid not.
Oh, go fuck yourself, I said.
I see I caught you off guard. I like to go for grandeur, and it is here that I will ask you one question, Andrew. If your answer is within an acceptable parameter, then you won't have to worry about anything else for the rest of your life. However, if your answer is unsatisfactory, well then, and only then will I kill you and let your body here float among the infinite vastness. I'll give you a choice. It is entirely within your realm of control. Is that not kind? I've always given you the choice. I've pulled heaven through hell to give you this choice.
Oh, how kind of you, I said. He looked at me, confused. If the choice is to join you, then you can forget it. I'm not teaming up with a megalomaniac.
Team up? I can't believe you consider yourself anywhere near an equal. I have to say you are much funnier than your father. No, that was not my question.
Then what is it?
I wish to inhabit your body. You could keep your consciousness. It'd be the minority, of course. That is a necessity. But you would remain alive. You would get to experience all of this world and the real world's pleasures. Anything you wanted could be yours. All at no effort to yourself.
That is by far the worst sales pitch I've ever heard. Jack shrugged.
I'm a scientist more than a salesman. You can't say that I didn't try.
Did you honestly believe I'd say yes?
Oh well. So your answer then is no?
Yes.
Unfortunate. You wouldn't believe the kind of people that say yes when their backs are at death's door. Even the purest of heroes eventually break. You're no pure hero yourself.
No. But I'm the hero who's gonna kick your ass and put an end to your bullshit.
Not the first person to say it, not the first to fail.
He smiled. He took out a ring of keystones from under his coat. They all shined brilliantly on the ring. He marveled. How do you have them?
I assumed you could have figured that out. I wanted them, and so they came. It is that simple.
That's...
not fair. You're not the first to say that either, Andrew. Face it, everything you have said and done, will say and will do, has been done, said, and tried before. You're far from the first, and you shall end up like all the rest.
Fuck. What do I do in this situation? I'm royally fucked.
No, you're not.
My mental eyes opened wide, and I was looking out through Jay's eyes back in the Republic Plaza. I don't know how I knew they were his, or that's where he was, but I just knew. I felt a reassuring feeling deep inside my core.
You have Radical 9 flowing through your system. He brought you where you are because he's scared of you. He's scared of all of you. You all pose the risk of dethroning him from his kingdom he's built up. He wanted to take over you because he thinks that you could be stronger than he is.
Use that against him. There is something that I can do. I thought of each and every player in this game and I closed my eyes. I thought of ejecting them one by one. I felt around like a giant hand in my mind, scooping them up and holding them tight, breaking the helmets of every single player that still remained in this game. I smiled when I felt that hand close over the last person.
What did you do?
Jack asked. You baited me into hating you, I said. You knew I was infected with Radical 9. Probably guessed I had the ability to see things. Probably guessed that I might awaken into a new power and my life was on the line. That's what happened to you, right? You were on death's door and look what happened. A new man.
How do you know that?
You thought that by baiting me you'd get your fresh body, without the attached consciousness. Because you knew you could take over me at any time you wanted. But if my consciousness existed within it, then you were scared I could take you over.
I am not scared of anything!
You were terrified, so you led me here so you could break me to my last legs, literally and figuratively, so you could have everything that you wanted. I started to shake my head. But I won't let you. I released all the other players. Just like that. It was easy.
No! This isn't how it is supposed to be! Leave my work alone!
He rushed me, but he faced a wall. He pushed against it and made some leeway. He was making quick work of it, but I could tell he didn't expect there to be a wall in the first place.
You son of a bitch, come here!
I'm leaving, Jack. I know I can't kill you here, I said. I've been against killing from the very start. You knew that. You tried to exploit it. But guess what? You're gonna get what you want. I'm only gonna kill one more person. It's gonna be you.
You are doing nothing but feeding on the slugs of the earth!
Goodbye, Jack, I said, seeing the world around me vanish into a dewdrop. I know about Megan. She was an accident.
Andy, you have to look where you're walking.
Sarah bends down to pick up the can of soup that had rolled up against her foot.
Huh? Oh, I'm sorry, I wasn't...
I begin, my thoughts distant with our mission at hand to find John.
No, it's fine, just watch next time, will ya? Sarah says.
Here, let me help you with that. We've blown up the car with these? I ask. She nods. I don't know how much of it is good, to be honest. The canned goods should be fine, but the others I just guessed and grabbed.
Ditch the popcorn. We won't be near any microwaves anytime soon. Plus, they dry out after like half a year anyway.
I think it's been here for much longer than that, I said.
Oh, okay.
Rest of this stuff should be good, I say.
I'll get these, actually. Go and grab Lindsay for me, okay?
I woke up and I guess she must have gotten up before me. I think she was in the bathroom.
Alright, you be careful. Don't collide into anyone else, Sarah jokes.
Yeah.
Oh, after there's an open drawer in the kitchen. It's full of spoons and knives and forks and like, grab some so we don't have to eat like Neanderthals, would you?
Will do.
Oh, and also grab a can opener.
Got it, I say, nodding. Sarah nods back and turns around on her heels, walking towards the staircase. In front of her, there are 7 doors she noticed yesterday, but now only one of the doors was actually open, the one that Andy had come out of. She steps inside slowly.
Hey, Lindsay, you in here? We're getting ready to go.
There isn't a reply back. She looks over to the bed and sees the sheets strewn about everywhere. The pillow on the farthest side had fallen onto the ground, and the one closest to her was balancing on the edge of the bed for what seemed to be dear life. Sarah turns to the bathroom and sees the light is on from underneath the door.
Hey, in there? Hello? She walks up to the door and knocks once. Once again, no response. She reaches for the handle to try to twist it open, but it doesn't budge. Now she's pounding on the door. Lindsay, open the door! What's going on? She's pounding on the door and pulling on the handle until she hears footsteps behind her.
What's going on? Is the door locked?
Jay asks, out of breath. I think Lindsay's in there, but yeah, the stupid thing won't open.
Gotcha.
She steps back as he takes the doorknob in his hands. He twists it a little until he sees that it won't open that easily. Gotcha. Jay readies his shoulder as he takes a few steps back. Be careful. He gets a nice start as he rams the door once. It stands strong, much stronger than it looks, to be sure. Jay recoils a bit and rubs his arm. That isn't coming down anytime soon. Do we have any other ideas?
Maybe there's something else we can use to break the lock.
Did you see anything like that in the kitchen?
It certainly could be.
It certainly could be. Hey, something up? Sarah looks up to see me in the doorway, looking straight at them. Oh, Andy, we're trying to get this damn door open. We think Lindsay's inside. Really? I don't think I heard any noise coming from in there when I woke up. The light's on, though, Sarah says. I didn't turn it on. Shit, I say, looking back to us. We have to get this door open now! Andy says, running up to the door and grabbing the doorknob. Andy, wait! Sarah's interrupted by the sound of the tumblers unlocking and the door slouching open slowly. Inside, I see Lindsay. She's lying against the toilet with one of her legs outstretched, the other bent to her chest. Her face looks lifeless. Blood dribbled from her lips onto her top, and in her left hand I could see what looks to be an empty pill bottle. She'd refilled only a few weeks ago. I fall to my knees, my heart dragging me down as it sinks into my stomach. I check for a pulse in the faint hopes that what I know to be true is not. She's gone. Guys, she's dead. My insides have been ripped out. This would be a time where I'd look to Lindsay for help, where she'd convince me everything was going to be okay, and I'd do the same for her. We bounced everything off of each other. That's why I can't even believe my own eyes right now. Cannot believe that this is anything that could ever happen in any world, ever. There's no way she wouldn't have told me. That's what they all say, right? When someone close goes. I'm being shaken from behind. I turn to see Jay pulling on my shoulder, and then Sarah lending him a hand and yanking me out of the bathroom. Everything feels so surreal, as if it were in a dream. As if there were some figment of my imagination, a nightmare within a larger nightmare. The door shuts and we're all just looking at each other silently. Andy, I don't... I remember screaming. I remember thrusting my arm out. I remember the look on Jay's face as he flew backward. The surprise at what was happening and what must have been acceptance that it had. I remember his body slamming so hard against the wall that the impact sound was only dulled by the sound of his back cracking. I remember his body falling to the floor and his head lolling off of the ground. I remember the smell of blood filling my head and seeing it pool underneath his body. I remember Sarah's scream. Jay! She turns her head to me. What the hell was that? I lean in closer to the wall, not wanting to turn around, not doing anything else other than breathing. My head pounds to the beat of a million tiny drummers.
Everything around me hums in a faint sound, and it all overwhelms me. I push myself up, and my legs are shaking.
Well?
She asks me. Is he? I begin.
He isn't breathing, Andy. What do we do?
Sarah asks.
I don't know. God damn, this can't be happening right now.
She looks for his pulse again. He's gone. I run my hands through my hair and let out a long, exasperated breath.
Fuck!
I don't know what to do with what I'm feeling.
Fuck, I didn't mean for any of this to happen.
Go down to my knees again.
Fuck!
Breathing is a luxury that I just shouldn't have. My heart just keeps on beating.